गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव लर्नड द ड्यूअल एस्पेक्ट कंसेप्ट एज ए प्रिंसिपल ऑफ अकाउंटिंग एंड वी नो दैट एवरी बिजनेस ट्रांजैक्शन हैज ए ड्यूअल एस्पेक्ट, दैट इज ड्यूअल इफेक्ट. दिस प्रिंसिपल इज एक्सप्रेस्ड इन टर्म्स ऑफ एसेट्स इज इक्वल टू लायबिलिटीज प्लस कैपिटल. इट मीन्स एसेट्स ऑफ द बिजनेस आर ऑलवेज इक्वल टू इट्स कैपिटल प्लस इट्स लायबिलिटीज. लायबिलिटीज मीन्स आउटसाइडर्स लायबिलिटीज एंड कैपिटल मीन्स लायबिलिटी टुवर्ड्स द ओनर ऑफ द बिजनेस. ओके, बिकॉज वी नो दैट कैपिटल मीन्स अमाउंट इन्वेस्टेड बाय द ओनर इन टू द बिजनेस. सो दिस इज लायबिलिटी टुवर्ड्स ओनर एंड लायबिलिटीज मीन्स outsiders liabilities, that is external liabilities. So assets will always be equal with total of capital and liabilities. From today onwards we will learn how to solve all the business transactions in terms of accounting equation. This equation is assets is equal to liabilities plus capital. It means A is equal to L plus C. So if we want to calculate capital, then we can calculate like this: A minus L is equal to C. To calculate capital, we have to deduct liabilities from assets. Okay? Then, if we want to calculate liabilities, then A minus C is equal to L. It means we can calculate liabilities after deducting capital from the total assets. Okay? This is the basic accounting equation. And now we will start solving the problem. Now we will solve the accounting equations. I have given one problem here. Prepare accounting equations from the following. There are 6 transactions. First, Gopal started business with cash rupees 50,000. Second, purchased goods. Second, purchase furniture rupees 5,000. Third, purchase goods for cash rupees 20,000. Fourth transaction is purchase goods on credit rupees 15,000. Fifth transaction, sold goods rupees 10,000. And last transaction is sold goods on credit rupees 5,000. These are the transactions given and we will arrange them in the form of accounting equation. Okay, let us start. This is the table we have to prepare. First column is of transaction. We will write transaction here. And this is the accounting equation. Assets is equal to liabilities plus capital. Okay. First transaction. Started business with cash. They told us that Gopal started business with cash rupees 50,000. It means asset of the business is increasing. So we will write cash here. Cash is equal to 50,000. Okay. P is equal to, there is no liability, so dash. And capital will be rupees 50,000 because Gopal has given rupees 50,000 to the business. Means liability towards owner will be rupees 50,000, which is called as capital. Okay, so this is the first equation. We will make the total of this equation. Total assets total is rupees 50,000 is equal to total of liabilities and capital is rupees 50,000. Now the second transaction. Second transaction is purchase furniture rupees 5,000. So I will write here purchase furniture. You know that furniture means tables and chairs and cupboards, etc. Purchase furniture rupees 5,000. So as the owner means as the owner's business is purchasing furniture for his business. So cash of rupees 5,000 will be going out. So we will deduct cash is equal to 50,000 minus 5,000, that will be rupees 45,000. Okay, and it will create a new asset, that is furniture is equal to 5,000. There will not be any change in liabilities and no change in capital. Okay, so now we will tally this equation. Total of assets is rupees 50,000 is equal to rupees 50,000. The equation is tally. याचा अर्थ असा आहे की बिझनेस मध्ये कॅश 50,000 होती, जेव्हा फर्निचर परचेस केलं बिझनेसनी त्यावेळेला 5,000 कॅश आपल्याकडनं बाहेर गेली. सो वी हॅव डिडक्टेड रुपीज 5,000 फ्रॉम 50,000. सो कॅश रिमेन्स विद द बिझनेस इज रुपीज 45,000. अँड देन नवीन ॲसेट निर्माण झालेली आहे फर्निचर नावाची, जी 5,000 रुपयाची आपल्याकडे आहे. सो ॲसेटची टोटल 50,000 झालेली आहे, जी लायबिलिटीज आणि कॅपिटलच्या टोटल बरोबर टॅली होते, कारण ती टोटल पण 50,000 आहे ॲज देर इज नो लायबिलिटी. ओके, नाव द थर्ड ट्रान्झॅक्शन, परचेज गुड्स फॉर कॅश रुपीज 20,000. सो विल राईट परचेज गुड्स. रुपीज, नो नीड टू राईट रुपीज, परचेज गुड्स इज ओके. नाव द बिझनेस इज परचेसिंग गुड्स, सो देअर कॅश विल गो आउट फ्रॉम द बिझनेस, त्यांची कॅश बाहेर जाणार आहे बिझनेसमधनं. सो आधीची कॅश 45,000 होती मायनस रुपीज 20,000 इज इक्वल टू 25,000. सो कॅश विल रिमेन रुपीज 25,000 विथ द बिझनेस. फर्निचर इज अवर ॲसेट विच विल रिमेन ॲज इट इज, देर विल नॉट बी एनी चेंज इन फर्निचर. And new asset has been created, that is goods. When we purchase goods, we will call it as purchases. So, purchases, that is goods. You can write goods also for better understanding. Goods is equal to 20,000 because we have purchased goods of rupees 20,000. Cash 25,000 उरलेली आहे, furniture जसंच्या तसं राहणार आहे आणि गुड्स नावाची नवीन ॲसेट आपल्याकडे येणार आहे 20,000 रुपयांची. देर विल नॉट बी एनी चेंज इन लायबिलिटीज अँड नो चेंज इन कॅपिटल. सो टोटल टोटल 25,000 प्लस 5,000 30,000, 30,000 प्लस 20,000 विल बी 50,000 इज इक्वल टू डॅश प्लस 50,000. म्हणजे अकाउंटिंग इक्वेशन टॅली झालेलं आहे या ट्रान्झॅक्शन नंतर सुद्धा. मी ते कंटिन्यू करते, स्पेस कमी असल्यामुळे. थर्ड ट्रान्झॅक्शनची टोटल होती 50,000 इज इक्वल टू डॅश प्लस 50,000. नाव द फोर्थ ट्रान्झॅक्शन, परचेज गुड्स ऑन क्रेडिट रुपीज 15,000. परचेज गुड्स on credit, you will write. We'll write purchase goods on credit. It means we have purchased goods but payment is not made. म्हणजे goods purchase केलेले आहे पण पैसे दिलेले नाही, म्हणजे उधारीने माल purchase केलेला आहे, goods purchase केलेले आहे. ओके, we have cash of rupees 25,000. See the last equation. Furniture of rupees 5,000 and goods of rupees 20,000. We can also call as purchases here, goods of rupees 20,000. We have cash of rupees 25,000 because from 50,000 we have deducted 5,000 plus 20,000. So cash remains 25,000, furniture as it is, and purchase goods for cash, so goods rupees 20,000. Okay, now were purchasing goods on credit rupees 15,000. ओके म्हणजे आपण 15,000 माल उधारीने परचेस करतो. As we are not paying amount, our cash will remain as it is here, that is rupees 25,000. Furniture will remain as it is, but as we are purchasing goods, we will increase our goods, that is our asset, by rupees 15,000. So plus 15,000, so goods amount will be, total goods will be of rupees 35,000. Understood? कॅश तशीच्या तशी राहणार आहे, फर्निचरमध्ये काही फरक पडणार नाही, आणि जे जुने गुड्स आहेत 20,000 त्याच्यामध्ये नवीन जे आपण उधारीने गुड्स परचेस केलेले आहेत ते 15,000 ऍड होतील, त्यामुळे टोटल गुड्स 35,000 होतील. नाव आधी आपली लायबिलिटी काही नव्हती, बट वेन वी परचेस गुड्स ऑन क्रेडिट देर विल बी राईज इन लायबिलिटी. इट मीन्स हिअर द लायबिलिटी विल इन्क्रीज, दॅट इज क्रेडिटर्स is equal to 15,000. We have learned the term creditor. Any amount payable to anybody, that person or that institution will be our creditor. The name of the person is not given here, so we will write creditor, rupees 15,000. Okay, our liability has been increased because we have to pay back rupees 15,000 in future. And now there will not be any increase or decrease in capital, so it will remain as it is 50,000. Now we will make total. Total ka bhiya? Total 25,000 plus 5,000, that is 30,000 plus 35,000, means total 65,000 is equal to creditors 15,000 plus 50,000 capital, so 50,000 plus 15,000 means 65,000 is equal to 65,000. Okay, now the next transaction, fifth. Sold goods rupees 10,000. Sold goods rupees 10,000. For cash or on credit is not given here, so it means this is a cash transaction. Okay, it means goods sold for cash rupees 10,000. आपण गुड्स सोल्ड केलेले आहे आणि पैसे आपल्याकडे आलेले आहेत असा अर्थ होतो त्याचा. म्हणून as we are receiving cash, our cash will increase here, so cash is equal to 25,000 plus we are receiving rupees 10,000 here, so 10,000 आपली कॅश वाढणार आहे, कारण आपण गुड्स सोल्ड केलेले आहेत 10,000 रुपयाचे, गुड्स आपण देणार आहोत आणि कॅश आपल्याकडे येणार आहे, सो कॅश विल इन्क्रीज. फर्निचर विल रिमेन ॲज इट इज, फर्निचर इज इक्वल टू 5,000, इट विल रिमेन ॲज इट इज. अँड देन गुड्स, वी हॅव टोटल गुड्स ऑफ रुपीज 35,000, वी आर सेलिंग गुड्स वर्थ रुपीज 10,000, सो we will deduct rupees 10,000 from this 35,000, so goods will remain of rupees 25,000. There will not be any change in liabilities, so creditors, that is our liability, which is 15,000, and capital will remain as it is, that is 50,000. Now we will make total. $35,000 plus $5,000 is $40,000 plus $25,000 means $65,000 is equal to $15,000 plus $50,000 means $65,000. Okay, and now the last transaction. Now the last transaction, that is sixth transaction. See the transaction. Sold goods on credit rupees 5,000. It means we are selling goods, but on credit means we are selling goods, but the amount is not received yet. Okay, याचा अर्थ goods आपण उधारीने सेल केलेले आहे, आपण उधारीने सेल केले कोणत्या तरी पर्सनला, पर्सन्स नेम इज नॉट गिवन हियर, द पर्सन हु इज purchasing goods from us on credit is called as debtors. It means debtor is our credit customer. Okay. So here new asset will be created, namely debtors. See how it is. Sold goods on credit. As we are not receiving cash, cash will remain ₹35,000. Okay, furniture ₹5,000 as it is. Goods. There were goods costing ₹25,000 and we are selling goods of ₹5,000. So, 25,000 minus 5,000. अपन goods sold के लिए मुझे 5,000 रुपए नहीं अपने goods कमी होता है. So, अपने करे 20,000 रुपीज से goods रहते हैं. And now, new asset has been created, namely debtors. Debtors of ₹5,000. अपन 5,000 रुपए से goods credit वर sold के लिए आए, तो हमें debtors नवाची नवीन asset निर्माण झाले लिया है. Because this is amount receivable from the customer, anything receivable will be our asset. So debtors, this asset is created ₹5,000. There will not be any change in liabilities ₹15,000 creditors and no change in capital. So it will remain as ₹50,000. Make the total. Total. 35,000 plus 5,000, 40,000 plus 20,000, 60,000 plus 5,000, 65,000 is equal to 15,000 plus 50,000, that is rupees 65,000. Okay.